Hi there. My name is Trinath Reddy and I'm an educator for Law Entrance Exams here at Exams Hangout. In this session, let us understand as to how can we pursue or how can we study law in India after completing class 12. We know that there are some specific institutes for studying various specific courses. Say for example, to study engineering, the most sought after institutes are the Indian Institute of Technology or the IITs. For management, we have the IIMs or the Indian Institute of Management. Similarly, for law, we have what is called as a National Law Universities or the National Law Schools or NLUs. Let us understand as to what exactly are these National Law Universities and how to get into them and study law in India after completing class 12. Now let us understand as to what exactly are these National Law Universities. After the second generation of legal reforms in India, in 1986, the Karnataka State Legislative Assembly has passed the National Law School of India University Act, 1986. And based on this, in 1987, the National Law School of India University was established at Bengaluru. The National Law School of India University is considered to be the first national law university in India. And after a decade, in the year 1998, the National Academy for Legal Studies and Research was established at Hyderabad. So like these, many national law universities were established. And when these national law universities were established, the primary motive for the establishment of national law universities is to provide the state-of-art infrastructure and to provide quality legal education to the young law aspirants in India or the aspiring lawyers in India. After the introduction of these national law universities, each university had its own entrance examination. So to get into any national law universities, an aspirant has to apply for multiple examinations. So this has become a major trouble to students as well as parents, because it will definitely have a financial burden on both students and parents. So in 2006, a civil writ petition was filed in the Supreme Court of India by Varun Bhagat, who is an aggrieved parent. In 2007, Supreme Court delivered its verdict in Varun Bhagat versus Union of India, and it has directed the universities to conduct a common entrance examination for admission to various national law universities. And on lines of this, the Common Law Admission Test or the CLAT was introduced in the year 2008. The Common Law Admission Test is conducted every year by the national law universities to admit students into various UG and PG courses. So after 2008, many national law universities were established and the common entrance exam was the Common Law Admission Test or the CLAT. As of now, there are 23 national law universities in India, and only one university in India that does not accept the Common Law Admission Test score, that is the National Law University Delhi. The National Law University Delhi has its own entrance examination, namely the All India Law Entrance Test or the ALET. Barring the NLU Delhi, all the 22 national law universities in India admit students based on CLAT scores. Now let us understand as to what exactly is the pattern and the eligibility criteria of the Common Law Admission Test. The Common Law Admission Test is conducted every year by the Consortium of National Law Universities, which has its permanent secretariat in NLSIU Bengaluru. The Common Law Admission Test is conducted as a MCQ type paper for the UG aspirants. In the UG question paper, after the 2020 CLAT reforms, the paper was reduced from 200 marks to 150 marks. And the Common Law Admission Test or the CLAT paper consists of mainly five major sections, namely English language, logical reasoning, legal reasoning, current affairs including general knowledge, and also quantitative techniques. English language constitutes 20% of the paper or 30 marks. Logical reasoning also constitutes 20% of the paper, or around 30 marks. Legal reasoning and current affairs, including general knowledge, coupled together constitutes 50% of the paper, or 75 marks. In particular, the current affairs and the general knowledge section constitutes 25% of the paper, and legal reasoning constitutes another 25% of the paper. And the quantitative techniques section constitutes 10% of the paper, or around 15 questions. So this is a composition of the common law admission test, or CLAT. So there is 1 mark for every correct answer, and the maximum number of marks is 150 into 1, that is 150. And there is 0.25 negative marking for every wrong answer. So this is the composition or the syllabus of the common law admission test. And next in major entrance exam to get into National Law University Delhi is the All India Law Entrance Test, or the ALET. So ALET also has 5 major sections, namely English, reasoning, legal aptitude, general knowledge, and also mathematics. English, logical reasoning, legal reasoning, and general knowledge amounts to 35 marks each, and the quantitative techniques or the mathematics section constitutes 10 marks, and the total number of marks is 150, and there is 0.25 negative marking for every wrong answer. So this is a pattern of the All India Law Entrance Test. So when we compare the Common Law Admission Test and the All India Law Entrance Test, the Common Law Admission Test has 150 questions, and the AILET also has 150 questions. But for the ALET examination, the maximum duration is 90 minutes, whereas for the Common Law Admission Test, the maximum duration is 120 minutes. So the reason is that the CLAT questions are very lengthy when compared to the ALET examination. So now you must have understood what exactly is the syllabus and the examination pattern of both the Common Law Admission Test, that is CLAT, and also the All India Law Entrance Test, ALET. So this is a primary agenda of this session. And in the next upcoming sessions, our mentors will discuss the strategies and in detailed or specific syllabus for various sections of the Common Law Admission Test, and also for the All India Law Entrance Test, and also we'll discuss about various other law entrance examinations other than CLAT and ALET. So that's all for this session. Bye bye. See you all in the next session.